Alright, hey guys, welcome back to another video. I'm YoYo, and today I'm going to be showing you how you can create this in Adobe After Effects. So, let's get right into it. So, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new composition. Name this dots, and then resolution 1280 by 720, frame rate 30, and duration around 10 seconds. It doesn't have to be that long. The color, I'm going to change it to a dark blue, and yeah. Alright, so now I'm going to go right click new, solid. Now I'm going to change the color to white, press OK, and name this beams, and press OK. Alright, so now I'm going to go into the effects and presets and type beam, and we're going to drag this onto the beam, solid, and we're going to change the color to white, and then the outside color to white as well. Alright, now I'm going to change the length to 100, the starting thickness to 2, and the ending thickness to 2. Then I'm going to change the ending point to 1280, the amount of size your composition is, divided 2, and that will make it straight in the middle. Now your starting point should be at the end, and you can drag that in and out, whatever you want it to look like. So I'm going to right click, just so that I can keep this organized, and name it beam L and beam R, so that I know which one is right and which one is left. Alright, so now I'm just going to drag it out until it looks good, and something like that, equal. Alright, so now I'm going to create a new solid. And I'm just going to, let's see, make the color blue, maybe a bit darker. Let's see what we got there. That looks pretty good. Alright, it doesn't really matter what color it is, but yeah, I'm going to go up to the lips, create a circle here, and so now I'm going to move this dot all the way over to the end point on the first line. And then I'm going to press G on my keyboard, or get the anchor point here, and move the anchor in the middle of the circle here. So I'm going to press Shift, and then make it smaller. Now what I'm going to do is Control-C, Control-V, and move the other one. It might be a little bit tricky to try and grab, but press Shift, and then move it on the other side. And these layers should be above the beams. Alright, so now I'm going to select one of these and press P, and press the other one and press P. Then I'm going to alt-click and type in wiggle, and then 1, comma 30. And then do that. And now what this will do is to give the dot a little bit of motion. Let's actually change that to 20, because it looks like too much. But you can change it to whatever. And I'm going to press the same thing there, wiggle, and then 1, comma 20, and press enter. So now there's a little bit of motion in these dots, and we're going to connect those to the other beams now. So let me just shorten my thing here. So now I'm going to go down to my beams, and I'm going to go all the way back up to the starting and ending position. And you have to make sure that you know where the dots are. So the starting position for my first line here is right there. So I'm going to go starting position, press Alt, and click this quick whip, and move it to the position of the first dot. And now you'll see that the line is moving with the dot. So now we have to do that with the other beam. So we press the second beam, go up to starting position, press Alt, and then click the quick whip here, and move it on the position of the second dot. So now you can see that they're both moving, and you can add as many as you want, but I'm going to just create one more, and how I'm going to do that is I'm going to press Control C, Control V on one of the beams, and then Control C. Wait, let me just rename this so that I get organized. And then Control C, Control V on the dot, press P, go into the starting position, press Alt. And then go up to the quick whip and drag that onto the position. And then now you'll have three. You can't really see the third one. It's in the middle, but it's there. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press shift on all the blue dots and press P and then make a keyframe right there. Move each one individually because you don't want them all at the same place. And this is where it gets sort of time consuming. So once you have all your different keyframes on one of them, you want to make sure that it pauses. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Control-C, Control-V on a different part, Control-C, Control-V on all the keyframes. And now it looks like it stops, and then it starts again. And the balls still have motion, or the circles, or whatever you want to call them, still have motion, so they'll still keep on moving, but it won't move the whole line a whole different other position. You can also do what I'm doing here where I sort of edit the path and it's in a curved direction. So once you figure out what you want to do and what you want to look like, I'm just going to give some simple things that I did. Now, I'm going to select all these keyframes and press F9. Now, this will make it a lot smoother and look a lot nicer. Now, I'm going to go into the graph here and change some of the amount of speed here. So it's basically how much how fast they go and how they get their velocity. And I'm just making this random so that we can go sort of quick here. Just move these endpoints in or out and it will affect how each keyframe works. So I'm going to do this to all of them so it won't all be the same and each dot just looks completely different from the other. And alright, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press shift on all of these and press the little effect there, and that creates motion blur. So that's about it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to leave a like and share it around. And I will see you guys next time.